TV in Milwaukee, MATC presents Stormwatch, a weekly video magazine documenting the activities at Milwaukee Area Technical College. On today's show, we go to the Green Energy Summit, where well-known celebrities and environmental experts discuss renewable energy options. Then we take a look at the MATC Music Department and go down to animation to see the work of one 3D design student. All this and more right now on Stormwatch.
Hello, and thank you for joining us on Stormwatch. I'm John Baer.
And I'm Tim Decker. We've got a great show ahead today. There are some exciting things going on.
You're not just saying that because we're going to be visiting your animation department today, are you, Tim?
Really? I didn't even know that.
Yeah, right. Anyway, that's coming up later. But first, the MATC Times visited the Green Energy Summit a couple weeks ago, and our own L.C. Satterfield was there as well.
Also, Steve Sanders uncovered some fun stuff to see and do at Discovery World. Let's take a look. Sorry about that.
The Midwest Airline Center in downtown Milwaukee is well into its fourth day of hosting the Green Energy Summit, where a wide range of subjects were addressed, from economics.
You want to raise price on things you want less of, and use the revenue to subsidize the things.
To renewable energy projects.
We are talking about renewable energy and energy efficiency opportunities within the commercial marketplace, around buildings in particular. You know, and the projects that we get involved in would be with renewable energy projects as well as energy efficiency projects. So we go into the building stock of the U.S. and really around the world and make those buildings more efficient and use clean sources of energy from renewables.
And the hot topic, water.
Water's a big one, you know. We're going to have some fights over water because there's a lot of water that's been contaminated, sadly. There are droughts in many parts of the country, and we need to do something to address our need for clean water and stop wasting so much of it. We waste a lot of water, and there's ways around that.
Then there were cars.
Columbia Parkcar is a Wisconsin-based manufacturer of 100% electric vehicles, both street legal, industrial, and commercial use. Operates with a 8 6-volt heavy-duty batteries, just like a regular vehicle. You've got your seat belts and heater defrost.
Finally, the engineers.
We were at the National Society of Black Engineers. Right now, we're here at this convention just to talk about ways that engineering technologies can be related to green energies. We have a few programs on the table right now. With
efficiency engineering, renewable energy, clean air, clean water, and more are all hot topics at this place.
It seems Discovery World has many areas to tour. Many folks come to discover different things that is fun for a family outing or playing curiosity. One example is the aquarium. I talked with Jeff Johnson, an employee at the aquarium, to learn more about this exhibit.
The aquarium actually is one of the highlights probably of Discovery World. In fact, they've even done surveys with our guests, and it always seems to be one of the top draws. I think our touch tanks probably are at the top of that too. Everybody, I've unfortunately seen some people just run down through the aquarium and come right to the touch tanks. It's a big draw. Our underwater ROV, or remote operated vehicle, is another big draw here in the aquarium. People can actually control that from in the underwater labs right now. So it's almost like a real life video game. Labs are a fairly new exhibit. They opened up just shortly after Thanksgiving. Each pod kind of represents a different thing, a different subject that they talk about. The first one deals with humans underwater, what kind of equipment they use, how they breathe underwater. The second pod talks more about something, ichthyology, which is the study of fish. It has different types of examples of fish that have adaptive camouflage. It also shows a dissection of one of our striped bass. You can go deeper and deeper into the fish until you're basically down to the bones. Some of the fish that we do have are the sturgeon, for example, that I mentioned. That's a very popular fish around this area. It is very protected, but it's been making a great comeback here in North America. We also show the Asian carp. Now, that's been really big in the paper because at this point, that's an invasive species that's right at the doorstep of Lake Michigan, and they're really hoping to keep it out. So that's another showcase animal here that we really want the public to know about.
There were all kinds of fish to look at. My favorite was the stingrays. But is it dangerous to touch them?
The stingrays have all had their barbs trimmed as an added precaution here. In general, stingrays are not aggressive. I know they've gotten a bad rap from the fact that Steve Irwin got killed by one, but for the most part, they really are not aggressive animals. But we never know here if somebody's gonna do something like try to grab one or where it feels it has to defend itself. So as a precaution, about on average, each one gets its barb trimmed about once a month. It's a process where we just take a pair of clippers and snip the barb. It's made out of the same material as your fingernails, and it does grow back. So it's monitored all the time.
If these are the jellyfish, then where are the peanut butter fish? I'm Steve Sanders, reporting for Stormwatch.
I get it. Peanut butter and jelly. Steve, you rock, buddy.
Now, here comes my pet topic, animation. There's a plethora, can I say plethora, on television, John?
Well, Tim, I believe it's a plethora, but I'm sure you do as long as you don't make me spell it first.
That's right. Well, anyway, there are many creative ways to channel one's artistic proclivities into a lucrative career. And MATC's animation department is an excellent choice for students looking to enhance their skills and bring inanimate objects to life. Ross Mungle has that topic.
And Lori Delaveri reports on the revised student loan policy in the MATC Solutions segment.
I'm Art Vinoy. I'm a fourth year student in the animation program at MATC. Hopefully gonna be graduating this year. And we're currently in the 2D drawing lab where students come first semester and learn how to create characters and how to move them about on a 2D page. I got into animation because I've always loved cartoons since I was a little kid. Really classic animation, Disney style, 2D hand-drawn animation is my real passion, but MATC's animation program has a focus on 3D digital animation, which I have grown to love. And the 2D and 3D really complement each other. They both really stem from design. I hope to actually start my own animation production studio, but until then, hopefully I can find a gig, maybe with a video game developer or in film. And it's a great program if you like to draw and want to see your drawings move. This would be the place to come and do that. Before coming here for the animation program, I didn't really have any other education other than high school. I did go to High School of the Arts, but MATC relatively recently, within I think the last 5 years, got the animation major or associate's program. And I heard about it and got excited and came down and checked it out. And it's really good. It's really cool. Being in my fourth year, we've had a number of different projects come through that are on top of our assignment-based projects that are client-based, where we actually have to work with outside entities from the school and relate to them and figure out their concepts and then, you know, interpret them into animation or models and design based on client-based projects. So, while I'm working on modeling and rigging, animating a main character for an upcoming television pilot that looks like it's gonna be picked up for national syndication. I can't tell you the name of it because it's still in production and I had to sign a contract. But that's kind of exciting. Other than that, working on short animation pieces for my portfolio so that because this is my last semester, at the end of the semester we're going to have portfolio night and I'll need to have a reel together for that, and then that'll also be what I'll use as a tool to hopefully get my foot in the door at production houses or, you know, some place that needs my talents.
Educational loan program for student loans, but they are in the process of changing to direct lending. Direct lending will start in the fall of 2010. Why the change?
Right now with the Family Educational Loan Program, students have to pick a lender, and so like a bank, like U.S. Bank, M&I Bank, a bank. And they also have a servicer which services the loan. So the bank gets a piece of that action, and so does the servicer. So if we go to direct lending, that eliminates the middle person, and the student borrows directly from the U.S. Department of Education. And the main change for students is they have to do a new master promissory note, a note promising to pay the money back. So everyone has to sign a new master promissory note, and they'll need to do that once, and they'll never need to do that again as long as direct lending is at MATC. And direct lending is now law. Schools don't have a choice as to what type of loan program they have. So starting in the fall, all schools will go to direct lending. We're getting the word out by, I sent out a mass email to all students. Marketing is putting it on the electronic signboards. It's on Facebook, on Twitter. There's gonna be an article in the Times, and I'm planning on sending out a postcard to students in the next couple of weeks. And also we'll be having sessions if students wanna come in and actually do their master promissory note with an MATC financial aid person.
To stay updated, be sure to check your student email, log on to Facebook, and read your tweets. You can also visit matc.edu for more information.
Speaking of animation.
But we weren't speaking of animation.
I was. And speaking of animation, you can see our work during student operations day on Channel 36. I had to get that plug in.
Finally, music is said to be the universal language, and everybody's speaking it down at MATC's music department. Tanya Billingsley takes us there.
Music, like all other art forms, can inspire, uplift, and unite the soul. In this journey, you will get the chance to experience firsthand some of the exciting reasons that bring students to the MATC music program to find out what this program is all about.
Ooh, it's like I ate a case of chocolate cream. Cream loves you. Put a temporary
The goal of the MATC music department is to get musicians to be competent playing any type of gig that might occur, from a rock gig to a jazz gig to classical, basically trying to get them competent and musically literate and proficient in their instrument. So the first year it's really dealing more with fundamentals of music theory and reading, and the second year of a little more advanced concepts of improvisation, composition, and music business.
The program is geared so that people have an efficiency on the piano, because that's like the basic instrument. You don't have to have any knowledge of it, but you have to go through a piano lab 1 and 2. They want you to be well-rounded, so you do have to go through the 1 and 2 just so you have a basic knowledge of it and can understand the theory and understand how it works. But you don't have to come into the program being a really good singer or even having any experience. If you have a passion for it, you can come in. And if you just want to take a class, you can do that as well. But as far as experience level, everybody has different levels of experience, and everybody is welcome.
The best thing about this program is getting the opportunity to collaborate with everyone. I mean, that there's a big emphasis put on working with others, and some of the coolest, I got, at least for me personally, I have gotten some of the coolest ideas out of working with other people down here.
It's really helped me to be not just a singer, but a musician as well, because I can communicate in the musician language as far as the theory part of it, and I think a lot of singers lack that, and MATC's program really puts an emphasis on that, so that when singers are going out and working with different bands, they can also sing but communicate the musical language. I like how it emphasizes all different kinds of music as well, so we're not just focusing on classical, we're not just focusing on jazz. They really push different types so that we're well-rounded.
I absolutely love this program. The instructors are so intelligent. They know their craft. It is an art form. And they make it exciting to learn things you really weren't interested in learning in the first place.
They teach you how to play jazz compositions. They work with you with classical music, which is one of the things that I want to work more on, because that's not my strongest suit. But then you have something like the music business classes, where you actually get to figure out how the business work as far as a record label is concerned. And then you have the studio classes that teach you how to work in the studio. Then you have composition, where you're doing film scores and things like that. So it's just a broad arena where you can have enough information to start building on that and learning on your own, or even when you decide to transfer to a four-year university, you have like a big, wide base of knowledge.
Oh, those are some talented students down there in the music department, but what other stuff you got going on in animation right now?
Down in animation, we just finished up a project for Milwaukee Public Television here for Student Ops Day, and that's called The Connections. And through Connections, I gave my students the opportunity to do whatever they wanted to do for animation for The Connections. And The Connections program with the Student Ops program, I think, is going to be a successful endeavor on our part.
That's great. All right, well, we hope you've enjoyed this episode of Stormwatch and that you'll catch us again next week. I'm John Baer.
And I'm Tim Decker. Be sure to watch Student Connections, Students Operations Day, May 8th on Channel 36. I missed that camera. Sorry.